The B2B buying experience is changing. In this panel, we'll discuss transforming the B2B buying experience. Facilitating the knowledge stream is Kevin Asher. He's president of Acoustic Selling, where he helps salespeople and their managers become more awesome by letting tech help them. Welcome, Kevin.
Thank you, Gene. Great to be here.
So our theme today, number 7, sales meetings, and I can feel eye rolls all over. What can we expect?
Well, the sales meeting, whether it's virtual or in person, that direct encounter between buyer and seller is where everything we do in the sales and marketing, where everything the whole company does, comes down to that moment when a salesperson's lips start moving. So we're going to go into how to conduct sales meetings in an excellent way. We're going to go through that in a lot more detail.
That sounds great. So I know you had a bunch of great panelists and thought leaders here and as part of the knowledge stream. Tell us about some of the panelists.
These are my paisan. I feel like I've gotten to know people like Famita and David and David and Michael and Paolo, because we've been on several panels together and they are constant, frequent contributors, and just, we wouldn't be able to do any of this without contributions from them and the other panelists.
And in your executive summary, buyers and sellers, well, they have different needs and you've got 4 key takeaways. Walk us through this.
Yeah. So it's not new theory, but to do it well is all the difference. And so we're coming in with different expectations and perspectives. And quite frankly, sales very commonly isn't even clear on what a great meeting looks like. And if you don't really know what you're trying to accomplish, well, then you're just kind of winging it. And that happens more than we'd like to admit. Good news is that delivering great meetings is coachable. It's learnable. You don't have to be a born finger quote salesperson. Oh, and then buyer traps are so fun. These are the mistakes that all of us have made. Some of us probably made way more than once. So we'll talk through those as well.
Great. So let's get started in key point number 1, starting with the seller. What should they know?
Well, productive meetings. You've got to, first of all, know where you actually stand. What the first quote from Famita is all about is trying to have more objectivity in distance, because what a person says, what a buyer says and what they mean are very often two different things, because they're human. And as humans, what we say and what we mean are very frequently two different things. So to cut through your own perspectives and biases and try to pick out only the things that corroborate your point of view, you have to read these cues objectively and have more of an objective, fact-based approach to determine what really happened in that meeting. And to determine what happened in that meeting against our yardstick of success leads to the second point, which is meeting objectives vary based on what stage in the buying and selling process we're in. A discovery call is going to have a lot different tone and format and content than a negotiation call with procurement. So being able to clearly and objectively and dispassionately assess what happened in the meeting and compare that to your yardstick that varies where we are in the overall sales process are the biggest keys we could offer right now to defining a productive sales meeting.
Wow. So in key point number 2, can we coach sellers to be better meeting givers?
Better meeting givers and receivers. I like how Joanna summarized it as it's a process. But like she said, there's the results, there's how the meeting went, you know, tone, tangible, mutually agreed upon next steps. Those are very specific checklist items that you could use for a basis of evaluation of where your seller is strong and in need of improvement. And again, back to a comment from Famita, shadowing great reps and seeing how they deal with these challenging situations is a great way to get new reps, newly transferred reps, underperforming reps, great performing reps, basically any rep, doesn't matter. The learning never ends. Having people shadow, and to the earlier point, having someone shadow to take notes, to alleviate some of the thinking, so the one seller isn't always on the spot are great ways to improve team performance.
That's great advice. So key point number three, what traps should we be avoiding?
Death by PowerPoint. PowerPoint, like any tool, in itself is neither good nor bad. So on the good side, it organizes your thought. On the bad side, it takes away all conversation. And your goal is just powering through awful slides that just distract and don't serve the purpose. Now, this other one, boy, this was sneaky. I had never heard of this, but wow. This was a story where there was a supplier who was a sole source supplier. The only problem is they didn't know they were sole source. The buyers did a great job of constantly sowing fear, uncertainty, doubt, and pressing on payment terms. And the selling team, every time the buyers jumped, they said not only how high, but you know, would you like me to shine your shoes? And if they had pushed back, come understood their points of leverage and just didn't always fold like a cheap suit or a pack of cards, they would have been able to maintain pricing and integrity and really understood where they accurately stood in the supplier matrix.
And then key point number four, buyers. What are the buyers' expectations for a productive meeting?
Yeah. So again, David being the professional procurement expert, he looks at it as, and this is great, I don't need to meet with someone who's transactional. I don't need to meet with someone who, you know, is just about price. I'll hammer you online. I'll do auction-based or e-commerce buying. I don't need you. So the key there is, how do you get out of transactional? And every company, there's not a company out there who will say they're a transactional vendor. Everybody thinks they're strategic. Comes back to being objective and having customers or market research to validate. Are you truly strategic? And if you're not, how do you get there? As far as the second quote from Paolo, he looks for buyers being more partnership in equality, basically treating vendors and suppliers from a point of equality. Because the point is, you never know where you're going to be in a bind and you're going to need their help.
That's a very good point. So it sounds like a really great panel with a lively discussion, a lot of great ideas. Tell us about three panelists who really stood out in this one.
Yeah, so Femita and Primo are, I believe, new to the leaderboard. So it was great to get their participation. David, again, offering his perspective from the buyer side. It was just fantastic. Out of the panels and knowledge streams that I have facilitated, I believe this one felt like the most engaged. It was a lot of fun.
Well, I look forward to our next conversation. Fantastic, Kevin.
Thanks, Gene. This was a lot of fun. Looking forward to doing this again in 2 weeks.
Kevin Asher, president of Acoustic Selling, where he helps salespeople and their managers become more awesome by letting tech help them. Thanks again, Kevin.